Hey everyone, how's it going? TechSmart here with a video today showing you hidden features of the brand newly released iOS 8. If you're interested in getting iOS 8 for yourself, stay tuned at the end of the video and you can find out how. Without any further ado, let's get into the video. Now obviously this isn't going to be a full list of hidden features, and we may even see some new ones added or deleted in future versions of iOS 8 beta, and definitely they won't all be the same when this comes out for public release in the fall. However, we're going to go ahead and take a look at some new ones that are available today in iOS 8 Beta 1. So without any further ado, let's get started. If we go in here and click on our camera app, the first thing that you're going to notice is that there's actually a self timer up here. So you can set if you want your camera to take the picture after 3 seconds, 10 seconds, or no self timer at all. This is a nice little feature. Of course, there's been apps do this in the past, but it's nice to see it finally baked into the OS. And if you scroll over here to the left past slow motion, there's actually a time lapse feature. This is kind of nifty. What it lets you do is set up your camera on a tripod or up against something, and then you're free to choose if you'd like to shoot pictures and it will save them. It's good for if you're photographing nature or a river or the night sky or something along those lines. It lets you take a cool time lapse. Again, there's been apps in the past, but it's nice to see it baked in to the actual camera app on iOS. Next feature is actually in Mobile Safari, and if we go down here, there is this really interesting thing, and you're able to see and request a desktop website. So if you're not sure what that means, is nowadays most websites are coded for a desktop version as well as a mobile version. However, sometimes not all the features are on the mobile version of the website. So what you may want to do is request the desktop website, which isn't going to be exactly formatted to work on the iPhone, but you will get to see the same one you would see on your desktop. Now, in the past, you could do this through third-party browsers. I believe you could do it through Chrome and such like that on iOS, but it's the first time we're actually seeing it as an option built right into iOS. So that's kind of a cool thing and something they didn't really talk about on stage today. If you make your way next into the Settings app and then move on to General, and then go ahead here into About, or actually go into Usage, and then click Battery Usage. This is a new thing. In the past, you have been able to see your battery usage, but never really in depth. Now you're able to see your last 7 days as well as your last 24 hours of battery usage. This is much like on Android, you can get a very detailed usage of your battery throughout the day. iOS has never really had this feature, but now it's prominent on iOS 8, and you can see which applications take up the most battery, as well as see how long you've been on standby and usage. So that's right in iOS 8, deep in the usage and battery settings. This one's not so much a hidden feature, but a little bit of a change that they've made. It goes on two things. So first of all, when you enter into Spotlight now, it does give you this little message saying that you can now use Spotlight for more than just searching your iPhone. You can search the App Store, movies, the web, and whatnot, and you get this little message. It hasn't gone away yet for me, but it may go away in the future. Also, something to notice while we're here looking at this is the actual emoji icon has changed. Not really a feature, but a nice touch. It looks like it fits more into the keyboard. It's gone from that globe now to the actual smiley face logo. Unfortunately, didn't see any new emojis with iOS 8, but you do get this nice little logo. However, you notice that there's this globe back here and not the smiley face logo, just a little bug that will probably get fixed on later versions. So if we hop back into our Settings app now, and we head over to our messages settings, there is this really cool feature, which something that they didn't really make note about, but it's definitely something that I figured is a little bit more of a bigger feature in iOS 8, is you can actually now erase messages or set them to erase after a certain amount of time. If you're not aware, usually when you get pictures, videos, a lot of iMessage or text messages, they begin to take up space on your device, and not many people know that, or at least the average user doesn't really know that. You can set messages to erase on your device after 30 days, a year, or you can leave it as it was before and they are kept forever. It's a nice feature for people who don't realize that having messages on your device can take up a lot of space, especially if you have a smaller capacity iPhone, and it's something that I think by default should be left to erase after 30 days or maybe a year, but it's a feature that they should definitely tote more, and they didn't say much about on stage today. If you go into Settings and go into your iCloud account, you now have this option to be looked up by email. It says that Apple allows others people to look you up by your Apple ID, and it'll appear here. They are able to see your first and last name. This is a new feature, and it kind of points towards the way of your Apple ID becoming more of a social thing. A little bit strange. It may be where Apple's heading in the future, but they're really trying to push iCloud integration here with a lot of their stuff, as well as their Apple ID. They want it to become very system-wide and device-wide thing, so that may be why this option is deep in the settings here. The weather app saw a big refresh in iOS 7, however, it got a little bit different even in iOS 8. So if we go over here and take a look, You're greeted with your custom standard weather app you're used to in iOS 7. However, if you scroll down here, you notice, first of all, that you now get many more days in your forecast. It's almost more than a week's worth of forecast, an 8-day forecast, as well as you get these little conditions down here, which in the past, you had always had to click up here to get them. No longer, you just simply scroll down and you get a little bit more in-detailed conditions, as well as this longer forecast. It's a nice change to the weather app and a little bit of a hidden feature. So one of the larger features touted with the release of iOS 8 today was the quick reply feature for messages and other system-wide applications. However, what you do normally is you pull down from the top to get your quick reply. I've kind of discovered my own little workaround here, and it requires first going into your settings application, and you're going to want to go to notifications, and then once you're in notifications, choose messages. Once you get to messages by default, you will have this banners option clicked, but if you switch to alerts, and then go home, what you're going to notice is that you get a little bit more of a byte SMS quick reply feel to this. And anyone who's jailbroken in the past and used that tweak, you'll understand exactly what I mean here in a second when I show you. So if I go in here and I send myself a message, and I'm going to quit out here quickly to get this, it's going to pop up here in a second. And as you see, it says one iMessage, and if you click view, you get the quick reply right on your screen. Now again, this could be better or worse depending on how you want to reply to your messages, but it's definitely a cool little feature right there. You can reply back, send it, and there you go. You never have to leave your application or exit the home screen or wherever you were, and it pops back up. So that is how you do quick reply, and it's something that I just kind of discovered on myself, and it's a different way to use quick reply messages. So another really interesting feature, which was actually talked about but wasn't really demoed, is the ability for Siri to act like Shazam, or it actually incorporates with Shazam and can listen to music that's playing around you. So I'm going to give it a test here and play a song and see if Siri is able to pick it up. So the song is Call It What You Want by Foster the People. And here we go. And there we go. So that was pretty seamless. It picked it up real easily. You notice that iTunes logo up above at the top of Siri there, and it gets the name of the song. You can go ahead and click buy. It will take you right to the iTunes store to do that. That's a nice little feature. Hopefully they add Spotify integration to that in the future, because that's one of the most used features I have, is going right from Shazam to Spotify. However, I could see Apple not doing that, as they want to try and keep it mainly focused on their apps and iTunes itself. So while we're on the topic of working with Siri, one other thing that I actually just discovered is the fact that you can say, hey Siri, hey Siri, there we go, and it will pop up. Now this is much like Google Now's service, where you can enter the Google Now launcher by just saying, hi Google, or what's up Google, or whatever you'd like to say, and it brings it up. So this is turned on by default, which is nice to see. So if you simply say, hey Siri, it will pull it up. A good feature for if you're driving, and something that isn't really made clear right away. You kind of have to figure it out on your own by saying, hey Siri. So that just about wraps up our hidden features video, but I want to show one last thing here, which was kind of interesting before we go. And if you scroll over to the last page of your applications, you actually get this bug reporter app. Now this is unique to people running iOS 8 beta version, but you can actually report bugs to Apple. And it's nice to see that they're letting that be a little bit more open, and they're taking feedback from users itself. Now that brings me to the point of, if you're interested in running iOS 8 beta, you can do so right now without having to wait until the fall when it's publicly released. Simply go to iosbetas.com, there'll be a link on the screen as well as down below, and you can instantly be registered to start running iOS betas, because you do need to register your device before you can do that. There are directions as well as everything else you could need once you go over and register on iosbetas.com. Thanks so much guys for watching this video, I hope you liked it. Please let me know if you have any other features that we weren't able to find, or something that we might have missed. Leave a thumbs up down below, as well as a comment letting us know if you liked the video, and I'll see you in the next one.